All right, we're back today. This is part two of cellular inflammation, and we're gonna primarily focus on glutathione, okay? Glutathione really does about three things in the cells that we're really gonna, you know, kind of talk about here. Number one, it helps to detoxify the cell. Along with another antioxidant called metallothionein, okay, it helps to basically attract heavy metals, okay? So it basically pulls them out like magnets. So the lead, the aluminum, the mercury, and it takes them out and it takes it back to the liver for excretion, okay? Number two, it works as an antioxidant, and I'll define what an antioxidant is. And then number three, it works as a antioxidant recycler. So it actually helps to recycle other antioxidants, and that's really why glutathione is the mother of antioxidants, or why some people have deemed it as kind of like the fountain of youth, okay? And so, let's explain what an antioxidant is first. An antioxidant is something that neutralizes free radicals, okay? Well, what's free radicals? Well, free radicals are basically an unstable compound that's missing an electron pair, okay? You all know that we're made out of protons, neutrons, and electrons, and these electrons are floating around. So let's diagram this. Free radical, okay? Electrons floating around, and in order for it to be stable, it needs to be paired with electrons, okay? But a free radical is missing this electron, and so therefore it's trying to get it from your cells, it's trying to get it from your mitochondria, it tries to get it from your DNA, and as a result, those structures damage over time. If you nick something enough times removing that electron out, eventually you'll have cellular destruction, okay? What glutathione does, and remember glutathione is abbreviated by GSH, is it actually donates its electron pair, therefore neutralizing this free radical, and now the free radical is happy and it goes away, okay? And it's neutralized. Now, in giving away its electron, glutathione now becomes oxidized. And this is just the oxidized form or abbreviation for glutathione, but this is inactive, okay? This can't bind to any more free radicals until it recycles back into glutathione, okay? Now, what are some of the things that basically help to recycle this? Well, these are things that I recommend to my patients. This is N-acetylcysteine, okay? Alpha-lipoic acid, or ALA, selenium, cordyceps. Cordyceps are actually a fungus, and there's lots of research on cordyceps now and its ability to really fight cancer. So again, I think I mentioned PubMed last time in the video. Lots of articles on cordyceps on there, okay? The biggest thing that really helps to recycle this is vitamin C, okay? So you wanna make sure that you've got plenty of vitamin C. And the way that I instruct my patients to do this is you take vitamin C to bowel tolerance, meaning that you take enough vitamin C to actually induce a bowel movement, and then you take one less of a dose, and that's your maximum effective dose. Okay, that way you know, because really vitamin C is that rate limiting step. You can have all this, but without vitamin C, it doesn't happen, okay? So this recycling is very, very crucial to keeping high amounts of glutathione in your cell, okay? Now, a lot of my patients don't understand this. They just have a glazed look on their face when they try to explain this, okay? So I've come up with a way to kind of break it down so that you might be able to understand it, okay? So here goes. Have you ever been in a relationship with a person who's just so needy, right? And you just constantly have to give and give and give? It's exhausting, right? It's destructive. Well, that's what's going on here. You've got a free radical that's constantly needing an electron, and that's what glutathione does. Glutathione is that person that just constantly has to give and give and give to shut this person up. I think I'm revealing too much about my personal life, but I'm kidding. Just trying to make light of the subject. But that's basically what's going on. So if you don't understand these electrons, if you don't understand what glutathione is and what all these things are, just kind of understand that, you know, a free radical is something that just wants to take, and glutathione is basically something that's giving to basically calm this whole thing down, okay? All right. Now, what are some of the things that can basically deplete glutathione in our cells? Okay, these are, number one, the toxins, okay? So where can I write this? So let's write this here, toxins. And toxins are basically from our environment, right? Basically the air that we breathe, the water that we drink, the pesticides in our food, okay? That creates or inflammation or minimizes glutathione inside the cell, okay? Number two, leaky gut. And this is something, if you're in the autoimmune population, you might know a little bit more of. I don't want to delve into too much about leaky gut. That's probably another video on its own as well. Leaky gut creates all kinds of inflammation, and it really is one of the driving forces of autoimmunity, okay? Number three, along with leaky gut, you have food sensitivity. So a lot of the foods that we eat, food sensitivities, okay? A lot of the foods that you eat, you probably may even be sensitive to or have an allergic response to, and you just don't know it, and that's a major source of inflammation, depleting glutathione, okay? Number four that goes along with this is kind of stress and blood sugar. So stress is one of those things that's going to constantly create cortisol or rises in cortisol levels, and basically it never goes down, and that has an effect on your blood sugar as well in terms of the insulin and insulin receptor responses, and it may create an issue with hypoglycemia or an issue with insulin resistance, so that's another thing. Number five, what can we do here? Normal everyday things that we do, okay? These are basically things like being out in the sun too much or too much sun exposure, okay? Overtraining, like such as training for a marathon, okay? That's something that really our body isn't really designed to do, but that's something that will also minimize glutathione, okay? So let's call this lifestyle. Okay, so in moderation, okay, try to do things in moderation. And then number six, probably, actually, this should be maybe even number one, but medications, okay? Because things like NSAIDs, you know, your non-steroidal anti-inflammatories, your aspirins, your Aleve, your ibuprofen, even Tylenol and steroids, huge in terms of really minimizing glutathione, okay? Nowhere to really put that on there, but maybe here, medications. Okay? All right. So, what kind of foods can you eat to basically boost your glutathione stores? Okay? Well, let's put that up here. And we'll put number one, cruciferous vegetables. Veggies. Okay, so these are your asparagus, your broccoli, your Brussels sprouts, your bok choy, okay? Number two, fish and chicken. So obviously you wanna make sure you're eating wild-caught fish or organic chicken. You don't want any of the steroids or antibiotics or whatever it is that they feed, you know, the chickens with, you know, free range, what have you. Wild chicken if you can, all right? Number three, mixed nuts. So these are your walnuts, your almonds, okay? Number four, garlic, ginger, onions, okay? Okay, I know if this is a whole mess now. Number five, fruits rich in vitamin C. Oops, vitamin C. Okay? All of this is basically this. Okay? Now, some people, you know, even with this in their diet, they need that extra boost, and so we have to supplement with this. And we have an actual supplement that has all of these nutrients. It's called Glutathione Recycler, okay? But let me tell you a little story. When I was younger, and I wasn't feeling well back then, or on days that I wasn't feeling well, my mom would make me this tea, and she would slice up some garlic and ginger and boil it with hot water. And she basically, you know, put that tea, and once it was done, squeeze half a lemon into it, okay? She had no idea she was actually quenching inflammation in my cells. She had no idea that she was raising glutathione in my cells, because I had no idea what she was doing. I just knew that it kind of, you know, gave me a pep, and it boosted my energy levels, and it helped me to feel better, okay? But that's basically what she was doing, that garlic and ginger, and then that lemon with the vitamin C. That's all the glutathione that you need there. So that's something that she did for me, and that's something that I'm going to pass along to you guys, okay? All right. Wow, this is a big mess. But hopefully, again, if you've learned anything out of this, hopefully you've learned to not be the free radical in the relationship. Okay, never mind. That's a bad joke. But hopefully, be the glutathione, right? Be the glutathione. Give. Give and give. And I'm Dr. Geronimo, and I also do relationship advice. All right. Take care. Bye-bye.